In 2007, LEGO released the UCS Millennium Falcon with over 5,000 pieces. In 2008, LEGO broke the record with the Taj Mahal with 5,923 pieces. 10 years later, LEGO released the Hogwarts Castle with 6,020 pieces. In 2009, another Millennium Falcon, this time around with 7,541 pieces. Last year, LEGO released the Colosseum with 9,036 pieces. And this year, with 11,695 pieces, the biggest LEGO set ever is a world map. Was this the type of set that we had in mind when we think about the biggest LEGO set ever? Probably not. But before I dive into that, let's review the thing as a whole, because a LEGO hard set experience usually starts with the box. It looks and feels like a premium product, targeted at adults with the 18 plus age marking, and you can already see some customization opportunities that the set allows. World maps don't always look the same around the world, and depending on where you live, your continent is usually at the center of the world map you're most familiar with. For me, it's Europe at the center, and I wonder if LEGO made different packagings to fit the different markets it will be sold at. Now, one of the best things about this set, and LEGO art sets in general, is the unboxing, because there is nothing more satisfying than holding bags full of one colored round plates and tiles. 10 different colors in total, with some of them having a couple of bags. Oh no, sorry, I was lying. The best thing is dumping all of the pieces. The boxes I used for this are Gliss boxes from IKEA. Great for sorting LEGO, by the way. After the plates, there's also this box hinting at an audio file you can download and listen to while building the set. And this box has 40 of these 16x16 LEGO elements that serve as the bases when building the sections of the map later on. The final inner box of the set has the remaining bags of elements plus the building instructions book. Now, if you've never built a LEGO art set before, it is a completely different experience when compared to regular LEGO sets. You get a sort of colored top down grid view with the colors you need to use, and these are also represented by a number in the building instructions. This set in particular also comes with a buildable color guide to help you identify the colors more clearly. If you end up with a bad quality print on the paper, or if maybe you have a hard time telling some colors apart, this may be of help, although I personally didn't feel the need to use it. The build itself is pretty straightforward. You follow the guide and place down the plates and tiles. Each section you build is connected to each other via Technic pins. After you're done with the 40 different sections, you then select the world map configuration you want and build the white frame. LEGO sent me this for review, and I had to rush the build in just 2 days, so I was able to shoot this video. Now let me tell you, placing 10,240 round plates and tiles is painful to your fingers. Thankfully, only the white color were regular round plates, the rest of the colors being flat tiles weren't as painful to build. But if you end up getting this set, you'll probably take your time building it, and you'll probably do so with someone else, so hopefully you won't face the same issues I did. Surprisingly enough, it wasn't boring to build, as you might expect it to be. I actually enjoyed doing it, and was very much looking forward to see the final result. Like I said before, it is a completely different building experience if you're used to building regular LEGO sets, but not necessarily a worse experience. And after some sections, you enter an autopilot mode, so you don't have to think too much about what you're doing, which was cool and relaxing. The map itself is a representation of a bathymetric map, which shows the depths and shapes of underwater terrain, where the vibrant color represents the highest points of the ocean floor, going all the way down to teal for the deepest points in the ocean. The land masses are represented by the white plates, and the dark blue acts as the shadow of the map, also helping a bit to highlight it against the super bright colors. The whole thing is super bright, to the point where it might be uncomfortable to look at. When I first saw the box, I was like, they messed this up. As a map, I'm usually more used to seeing green and blue maps with shades of brown, and this one is nothing like that. I've grown used to it by now, and I can understand the color choices by the designer. It definitely stands out and looks very artsy. I'm just not sure this will fit in every house style. Also, the frame is white, which I'm not so sure about. It does blend in well with white walls and can look amazing if your walls are a different color, or if you have wooden walls at your place like it's shown on the box. I don't. So I might have enjoyed it more in the end if it had a tan or black frame. Speaking of walls, LEGO Art products come with this special technique element that lets you hang the LEGO Art world map on your walls. It is an art product, and as such, the designer invites you to be creative with the ocean floors if you want to stay away from the bathymetric map, as in, build the white land masses and dark blue shadow, and then customize the ocean floors as you see fit. At the end of the standard build, you're left with lots of leftover pieces for that purpose alone. You also get the giant brick separator to help you take the map apart more quickly, and a crowbar element that I actually used a couple of times during the build to fix mistakes. An interesting addition to the set are these white cones that you can use to mark the places you've traveled to. But again, with all the white from the land masses, even if you place some tiles on top of the cones, they are the same colors as the ones you used all over the map. You can't really see the cones, so I would question the color choices here again. Some final thoughts on the set. The building experience for me was very enjoyable. It's quite different from what you are used to in regular LEGO sets, but I would give it a go if you have never tried a LEGO art set before. At $250 or euros, it has a very nice price per piece ratio, but 95% of the pieces are round plates and tiles, so there's that. Maybe because I'm somewhat old-fashioned when it comes to these things, but I think I would have liked more if the frame of the world map was tan, for instance, or maybe replacing the vibrant color tiles into red or a less extravagant color would have been nicer to the eye. Whether we like it or not, from June 1st this will be the biggest LEGO set ever produced, but it definitely isn't what I imagined the biggest LEGO set ever to be. I think I would have less issues with it if it was smaller than the Colosseum, but maybe that's just weird of me to say. I do want to know what you guys think about the set in the comment section, and be sure to subscribe so you don't miss the next LEGO videos and reviews such as this one.